Hey folks, how's it going? This is Bill with NSPCCC coming at you. And today we've got a nice little classic game that's been around since the beginning of time. We're taking a look at Tetris on the original Game Boy. This is card number 3 in the series. There's not a whole lot to say about Tetris that hasn't already been said, so let's just go ahead and take a look at the back of the card and see what we're doing. Alright, so the challenge is actually very simple on the pro level. Well, simple maybe for those of us who are Tetris gods, which I make no claim to be, but we need to get 40 lines, or essentially 10 Tetrises in a row, without a break. So, I mean, as I said, I make no claim to be Jonas Neubauer or Joseph Saley, but I do a pretty good impression in this video, if I must say so myself. Hope you enjoy this one. Alright, I said there's not a whole lot to say about this game, right? Well, yes and no. So if you're looking to play this game at the absolute highest level, which you will need to do if you want to be successful in this challenge or in the game, you need to know the highest level strategies here. And it's really not as difficult as you think. Basically, what you need to do is take a look at what I've done right here. I have one column either on the left or the right, and in this case, the right side. I have it completely open, and that's what you need to do because the challenge needs to get 10 consecutive Tetrises, right? There's the first one, and that's really all you're doing. You just have to set yourself up for success, leave one lane completely open, and just hope to the heavens that you get the piece that you need. Now, right about here, again, it's all dependent on getting that I or L pieces, whatever you want to call it, right? Sometimes you'll get it, sometimes you won't. Sometimes you're gonna have to reset this game an infinite amount of times until you get the RNG luck that you're looking for. I was very lucky to get the pieces that I want here, and once again, as I said, it just comes down to getting the correct RNG to get the L pieces that'll give you exactly what you need to get those 10 Tetrises in a row. That's really all it is. Get the right pieces, get the right RNG, and you'll get your 40 lines. Beyond that, there are some other basic strategies that you could look to employ, such as the tuck strategy. That really involves using some of the plus or whatever pieces you want to call those. Also the T pieces, whereas if you see a specific gap in the structure that will allow you to rotate and tuck the piece in, you can use that to your advantage. It's a very difficult move to master, but if you know how to do it, it will save you from having to reset yourself quite a few times. That said, oftentimes when I did this, you know, particular challenge here, I didn't even worry about that. I was looking for perfect RNG to where I would only have to worry about dropping L pieces down in the column. Again, if you know what you're doing and you've been playing Tetris for quite a while, you can look to do the tuck strategy and some of the other strategies that you might be familiar with for high-level players. Beyond that, if you don't want to torture yourself, just look to leave one lane open and drop those pieces right down the middle here. One other thing I would keep in mind for the modern or new age Tetris players as opposed to the OG classic ones. In modern Tetris games like Tetris Effect, for instance, you have the option to hold on to a piece that you don't like. You can save it for future use and then drop it out whenever you're in a pinch to fit it exactly where you want it. You cannot do that in this version of the game. This is one of the oldest versions of the game that there is. It is classic to the core. You have to use the pieces that you're given. So find a place to use it. Make sure you fill every spot. No gaps are allowed. If you have even one gap, you're done. So just forget about it. Make use of the pieces that you have to the best of your ability. Beyond that, it's skill, skill, skill. Do the best you can, drop those pieces in, get those Tetrises, and that's all there is to it. Beyond that, I really don't have a whole lot else to add that you haven't already seen or heard before. If you're looking for a true Tetris tutorial, there are plenty of great videos out there from the great Tetris masters, like the ones that I mentioned back in the introduction. Definitely seek those guys out. They'll be a great help to you, not only with this challenge, but with the game in general. So beyond that, feel free to watch the video to its conclusion. You will see the full 40 lines, and you will see that we did in fact tough this one out with another pro challenge gone down in the books. And that's going to do it for this one, Tetris Pro Challenge number 3. See you in the next one.